Hi everyone, this is Real World Audio and I'm continuing a little bit of report on those Harmony Technologies speaker cables that I took apart. You see, I am using them with the Quicksilvers, so they are running from here and I'm running them into the AOs, and you see right now they are just they don't have anything added to them. They are just bare wire, and that's how it is. So until now, for the past, since I stripped these cables, I've been running them with my triode amp to break them in, because after you cut a cable and you re-terminate the ends, then you need some breaking time for them to until everything settles down and they are able to perform properly. So what I did in the beginning is that I hooked them up to my triode amp and then hook these up into the Altec speakers. But it was a nightmare because I am running the crossover in a very peculiar way with those guys. And as you see, it's really a nightmare. So I had to connect all those things to those wires, and it was just a joy kill. I run into a really funny issue that I think all of you will run into, but you have to be aware of it, is that we had the Labor Day holiday coming up right at the time when I started the break-in, and with the holiday coming, the power AC, the AC that comes through the line, it just plummets and it sucks. It's just really terrible. I will make a report on how you can combat it, and John Sveda, he has given really good ideas that I will share with you what you can do to improve the supply for your electronics. But right now I just want to return back to what happened with these speaker cables. So basically what I noticed that if I use it as a jumper wire to hook up these guys, because I cannot hook up at the moment my speaker cables directly to the triode, because I have cut them in half and they do not reach to the triode. That's why I had to jumper them. But when you add the jumpering, of course that cuts in the quality, and it decrease the quality of the sound tremendously if you add an extra piece of wire as a jumper, plus also some paraphernalia to hold those ends together. So I was really unhappy with that configuration, but it's okay. It was just a test for breaking it in, and I just noted my experiences that if you just use any kind of extra wire to jumper to make sure you have a longer cord, you are going to have a huge cut in sound quality if you are using a non-feedback low power triode, and in my case they are pumping out a whopping 1.2 watts per channel onto those big boys. So in that scenario, it's a suicide if you want to jumper the wires. So going back here, of course that's something that I knew already and it wasn't a surprise, but I'm just sharing it with you that if you are planning something like that, that's what you can expect. And here I'm running these small baby speakers with the Quicksilvers using the speaker wire, and they project like an astounding, amazing big sound. So you would really never believe if you sit down in my couch that it's those baby speakers playing, because they play down pretty deep and the bass is very powerful, not overbearing, not something that's like a Terminator bass, but a very tuneful, very colorful, very, and I mean colorful, not colored. It's not like it has like a certain coloration that jumps at every song or every material you play, but no matter what you put on, everything comes up in a, is presented with lots of shades and lots of details. So that's what I mean, and for colorful bass, that you can identify the instruments. They have tonality, they have dynamic contrast, they have spatiality, and you just have a really natural experience, and it doesn't feel artificial at all. And even using a CD player, digital as a source, it really, really feels more analog than most vinyl rigs I heard. And this is where we are going to circle back to Yannick's answers on my on one of my latest videos. And I'm going to continue with that with the next video. And that's about vinyl versus digital. So thank you for tuning in, and we'll continue soon. Like, subscribe, tell your friends. Bye-bye.